Hello everyone, myself Mr. Abhijit Basaheb Shinde. I am working as an assistant professor in microbiology at Deshbhakt Anand Rao Pulwantrao Naik Arts and Science College, Chikli. In this lecture, I am going to give you a brief introduction about viruses. The term virus originates from Latin word meaning slimy liquid or poison. Dmitry Vianovsky discovered filterable nature of virus. He passed an extract of diseased tobacco leaves through a bacteria-proof filter. He inoculated filtrate into healthy tobacco plants. The healthy plants got tobacco mosaic disease. Therefore, he reported that the causative agent of tobacco mosaic disease is filterable. The term virus was first coined by Martinus Bejerin. The first virus discovered was tobacco mosaic virus. What are viruses? Viruses are acellular infectious entities whose genomes are either DNA or RNA that multiply only in their host cell using host cell's biosynthetic machinery and cause synthesis of new virus particles that can transfer viral genome to neighboring cells. Are viruses living or non-living? Viruses do not show all characteristics of typical living organism. They show certain non-living characters. These are as follows. They are not cells. They can be crystallized. They cannot grow. They cannot make food, take in food, or produce waste. They do not respond to stimuli. Viruses possess few fundamental characteristics of living organisms. These are as follows. They contain nucleic acid as a genetic material. They can undergo mutation. They multiply in living cell using cell's biosynthetic machinery. They are infectious. They are thermosensitive. They are sensitive to various physical and chemical agents. As viruses possess both characteristics of living and non-living organisms, they can be considered as a connecting link between living and non-living organisms. Characteristics of viruses. Viruses are ultramicroscopic and can only be seen with electron microscope. Their size ranges from 20 nanometer to 450 nanometer. They are acellular. They lack cytoplasm and cytoplasmic organelles such as cell wall, cytoplasmic membrane, flagella, pili, and ribosomes. They are obligate intracellular parasites. They can infect wide range of hosts, which includes bacteria, algae, fungi, protozoa, plants, and animals. They can be cultivated only in living cell. They have very simple structure. The simplest virus consists of nucleic acid surrounded by a protein coat. The more complex viruses contain envelope in addition to nucleic acid and protein coat. They possess only one type of nucleic acid, either DNA or RNA. Some viruses contain DNA, whereas others contain RNA. They do not have independent metabolism, as they lack genes and enzymes necessary for energy production. They can multiply using host cell's biosynthetic machinery. They exist in two states, extracellular state and intracellular state. In extracellular state, they are inert infectious particle, while in intracellular state, they are active and replicating. Thank you.